Hey guys, welcome to our lesson, Intermittent Fasting for Weight Loss. If you are new here to our channel, please make sure to like and subscribe for more exclusive weekly content. Before we begin, it's important to note that if you have a medical condition, please consult your doctor before trying intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting is currently one of the world's most popular health and fitness trends. It is actually not a diet, but rather an eating pattern, consisting of a small portion of your day spent eating, with a larger portion of your day spent fasting. So what exactly happens to our bodies physiologically when we fast? Well, fasting lowers insulin levels, increases growth hormone levels, and increases the release of a fat-burning hormone, norepinephrine. In addition, it promotes cellular repair and gene expression. Now, as we are always hearing about the advantages of lowering insulin levels for weight loss, let's have a look at why. When we eat, carbohydrates from a food are broken down in our bodies to glucose, or sugar. Our bloodstream then absorbs that glucose and, as a result, raises our blood sugar levels. Consequently, this increase in blood sugar tells our pancreas to create and distribute insulin into our bloodstream. Insulin then attaches to our cells and acts as a sort of key to unlock them in order to allow the sugar to enter. This, guys, is basically how our bodies convert glucose into usable energy. Now, conversely, if our bloodstream contains more sugar than our bodies need to function, insulin will signal to us to store the excess glucose from our bloodstream to our fat cells. That way, it allows us to have an energy source to use when our blood sugar levels run low between meals or while we sleep, for instance. So, what this means is that by lowering insulin levels via intermittent fasting, our bodies will have a lower ability to store fat with a higher potential to use fat stores for energy. Now, regarding weight loss, intermittent fasting's reduced time period allocated for eating by itself already provides a higher potential to stay within a caloric deficit. That said, it is very important to make sure we are filling up on protein and fiber, for example, during that time period to evade intense hunger as a result of the fasting, so we do not end up binge eating the following eating window. This is relevant as binge eating can actually create a caloric surplus for you, nullifying the previous day's negative energy balance. In other words, guys, only eating within a short time frame throughout the day is not a free pass to consume unlimited calories, especially if you are just starting intermittent fasting and are unaccustomed to your body's hunger cues. In addition, we also need to make sure that we are incorporating nutrient-rich foods, containing the important vitamins and minerals necessary for us to stay healthy. So, what does the research say on intermittent fasting's potential impact on weight loss? Well, in a systematic review of intermittent fasting in 2018 by Ganeset et al., it was reported that intermittent fasting was indeed effective for short-term weight loss. However, it was advised by the authors of the study that trials with long-term follow-up periods are needed to follow maintenance of weight loss from the diet. In contrast, another article suggests that intermittent fasting may be no more effective than other diets that restrict calories on a regular basis. A meta-analysis conducted in 2018 by Chioffi et al. Found that comparable results toward weight reduction were achieved between intermittent fasting and traditional diets. Additionally, the authors also indicated that longer trials are needed to draw definitive conclusions. And please note I have left links to the relative articles mentioned in the description if you would like further information regarding them. Thus, although intermittent fasting can be a weight loss tool that may help in the short term, there's minimal evidence of the long-term success from it, and a lot of the weight loss and health benefits can already be obtained by a traditional diet alone. By following the everything in moderation rule alternatively, we can maintain a sensible energy intake and stay within the caloric deficit needed to shed the fat. That being said, if you wish to undertake intermittent fasting to lose weight for the immediate future, have taken into account the pros and cons regarding health concerns, which we have covered in another lesson, and gotten the go-ahead by a doctor, how may you do it? Well, several methods of this eating pattern exist. Each may be beneficial, but deciding which one is most suitable depends on the individual. We'll first talk about the most utilized method, which provides an eating period alongside a fasting period each day. This method is a progressive one that starts small and increases intensity every few weeks. Before we start, we need to make sure that we are in a caloric deficit each day when we do any method of intermittent fasting, guys. Again, just because you're doing intermittent fasting does not mean that you can just eat anything that you want, as you still need to be in a caloric deficit to lose body fat. It's very important to primarily eat healthy foods during your eating window. This method won't work if you eat lots of junk food or an excessive number of calories. And yes, water and coffee are indeed allowed during the fasting periods. So let's look at level 1, which is 5 meals per day. Now these 5 meals consist of breakfast, then a snack, lunch, then another snack, and dinner. There is no fasting for this level, as it's just for your body to adapt to lower meal frequency. Moreover, after 1 week of level 1, we can move to level 2, which consists of 3 meals per day, including breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And again, there is no fasting required for this level either. It's just adapting your body to even lower meal frequency. Now, after 2 weeks of this, then we can move to level 3. Be aware that for levels 3 and 4, I recommend to count your calories to ensure we do not restrict them too much, to maintain optimal health, as the time periods for eating can already be very limiting for calorie intake. So we need to be mindful regarding underconsumption of calories in addition to overconsumption, guys. A good target to aim for is 500 calories below your maintenance caloric intake, which our lesson, Understanding Nutrition Labels for Weight Loss, explains how to calculate. So level 3 is 3 meals with 16 hours fasting. Now we still have breakfast, lunch, and dinner, but the only difference between level 3 and level 2 is that for level 3, breakfast, lunch, and dinner need to be eaten within 8 hours. Regarding this level, it's perfectly fine to stop here to achieve benefits of intermittent fasting. But for those who want to further decrease body fat and who are comfortable at level 3, feel free to try level 4 after 4 weeks. And what is level 4? Well, it is 2 meals within 4 hours coupled with 20 hours fasting. So you may choose to have breakfast and lunch, for example, or lunch and dinner. Now, of course, I realise that level 4 is very intensive, and that's actually the reason we highlighted this method of intermittent fasting, because it makes your body adapt to the intensity over a few weeks, so it could be easier. But again, guys, if level 4 is too difficult, there is no problem with staying on level 3, because level 3 does everything that we want to do. Furthermore, an alternative method of intermittent fasting is the 5-2 diet. This involves eating normally 5 days of the week, while restricting your calorie intake to 600 for 2 days of the week. For example, you might eat normally every day of the week except Mondays and Thursdays. For those 2 days, you would eat 2 small meals of 300 calories each. Now, what is also very important to consider is that intermittent fasting is not for everyone. It is not recommended for people with diabetes, hormonal imbalances, the elderly, in addition to pregnant and breastfeeding women. Moreover, people with eating disorders alongside underweight people with a BMI under 18.5 are also not recommended to use intermittent fasting. Side effects may also present as a consequence to the fasting, such as difficulty sleeping, constipation, and grumpiness. Again, highlighting the importance of consulting a doctor prior to starting intermittent fasting. Have you tried intermittent fasting already for the short term or even long term? What advice would you give to those attempting it? We'd love to hear from you in the comments section down below. Additionally, if you're new here, make sure to like and subscribe to our channel. So that has been our lesson, intermittent fasting for weight loss. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you in the next lesson.